see it before. She took her coat off, but Carol Baskin is right there. Okay,
and so we can't. She's shaking her head no.
No, because she has a tiger coat on.
Oh, because I was going to say, she looks nothing like Carol Baskin.
Derek,
she's got a cute little haircut.
Derek, let's make sure there's no talking. Okay, this table here is going to be very difficult because all three of them are what I call women. And women talk. Anyway, so we have a big week, right? This was the craziest week.
Yeah, it was a crazy week this week.
Mm-hmm. Who would have thought that in 21 you could say, 2020 wasn't so bad?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the first 10 days have been a rough one so far in 2021.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. What do you think it was such a big news week.
Yeah.
Right? And where I want to say to everybody is because we're getting fatigued.
Yeah.
We're getting COVID fatigued. So people are not wearing their mask when they should. And we have to tell you right now, here at the club, a couple quick things. You got to wear your mask. That's important because the mask can save your life.
Yep.
And it can save your way of life. For example, right, wear your mask when you're here.
Right.
And also wear your mask if any of you plan on storming the Capitol.
Yeah, to hide your identity.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you got your mask on, you got a little hat on, no one's going to know it's you.
Yeah. This is the easiest time in the history of crime to commit crime, and they stormed the Capitol without masks.
Right. Well, I especially like the people that stormed it and then took their masks for like a photo op. Like, how'd you think that was going to pan out?
Yeah, the guy
I don't know how they thought that was going to pan out, but I'm not sure why they did it. Like, if you're going to storm the Capitol, which I don't think is a good idea, keep the mask on.
Keep your mask on.
Yeah, keep your mask on.
If you're going to go into Nancy Pelosi's desk, Vicky got Nancy Pelosi's lipstick, and no one knew it was her.
No one knows.
My favorite one was a guy that took a table, and he had a mask on.
Yeah.
And he bashed a door open. Okay, if you keep talking, kid. Hey, kid.
Hey, Chatty.
Kid.
Chatty, we're talking to you.
You got to shut up. I was nice the whole time. Now you have to shut up. Okay, young Bruce Hornsby, listen to me. There's no shot in hell you're getting laid tonight. Just stop talking. She's got both her friends with it. You are shut out. It's an ice cold night. Shut up. Derek, please don't make me do that live. Please make sure. Thank you. I don't mean to embarrass you. I can actually hear your testicles shrinking from here. Now. So the kid, the guy like at the Capitol, he had a mask on.
Yes.
And he took a table and he bashed the door, and he took about 5 big shots.
Yep.
The door went open, and he turned to his friend and took the mask down and then put that on his Instagram. And then he got arrested, and he tried to say, that's not me. It's a better shot than your yearbook picture. It's unbelievable. He had 84 likes, all of them from Arkansas. It's you. We were amazed at that, right?
Well, I was more amazed at the people that were, like, parkouring it up the side of the Capitol. Like, I can't believe their acrobatic skills. Like, that was quite impressive. Like, I don't know if they set out to say, like, listen, I'm in great shape. I'm going to scale the wall. I don't know how it happened, but, yeah, a little crazy.
It was like the best version of America Ninja Warrior ever.
Yeah.
Just up and over the Capitol, bash a window in.
Mm-hmm.
I like some of the people after the fact. Like
the
guy that carried the podium got arrested.
Mm-hmm.
5 kids. He's upset. He didn't think that was a crime. I don't know. Maybe someone never did say to you, don't steal a podium out of the Capitol.
Right.
I was never told that. I just kind of had that general feeling that you shouldn't do it. And then my favorite is the video of the woman.
Yes.
We'll show it right now.
Yeah.
Crystal, you have that video. This is my favorite piece. Watch the monitors. Mm-hmm. My favorite piece from the storming.
Ma'am, what happened to you?
I got maced.
You got maced.
Yeah.
And what happened? You were trying to go inside the
Capitol? I made it like a foot inside, and they pushed me out, and they maced me.
What's your name? Where are you from?
My name is Elizabeth. I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee.
And why did you want to go in?
We're storming the Capitol. It's a revolution.
Thank you.
It's a revolution.
It's a revolution. The worst revolution ever.
Totally justified. Like, it was a revolution. How dare they mace me?
I think it's funny that she gave all the evidence. What's your name? Janet, my social security. It's 141723564. Here, my PIN is 7. Some of the dumbest people, and I don't care where you stand, all right? It doesn't matter to me. I can look out at the audience and know where some of you voted. I know. This is the Biden table. That was an easy one. You voted for Trump? You did? Who'd you vote for? Neither. Okay, that's a Trump supporter who's now.
Right.
That's what everybody says now. Oh, neither. It doesn't matter. Good. You voted for the Green Party. Oh, good for you. You may as well have just stayed home. Now, listen. I voted for the Green Party, but I drove to the poll in a SUV, a gigantic SUV. They took my ballot. They didn't give a flying crap. So don't storm the Capitol.
Right.
And wear your mask, right?
Yeah.
That's big news. What else is big news today? Read us down your list. You've got the list.
So our other big news is, so my stepson and his girlfriend, they're having a baby. So we hosted. Yeah, very exciting. We're going to be grandparents.
Yeah.
And we hosted a gender reveal at our house yesterday. It was super fun. I mean, it was just the 7 of us, so it's not like...
It was a gender reveal. Hey, Derek. Yeah, you got... Okay, the chatters, you got to stop them. The gender reveal party is not something that I ever thought I would enjoy, but our gender reveal party was awesome.
Our gender reveal party was awesome. It was. It was a lot of fun.
But the one we went to last week.
Right. So this was our second gender reveal party.
In a week.
Yeah. And yeah. We, you know, when we had our kids... That wasn't, I mean, you either just waited for the doctor to tell you when you gave birth.
Yeah.
Or at the 20-week mark, they told you. There was no big party. There was no cannons going off.
Yeah.
There's no, you know, for Vinny and Jennifer's gender reveal, I had a specific cake made. I had chocolate covered strawberries.
Yeah. There was no gender reveal.
No.
There was never, like, that's a young person thing.
Right.
And it's ridiculous, okay? My father didn't even know I was a boy. Until I was old enough to cut the grass. He had no idea. I remember it like yesterday. I was walking through the kitchen, and my father goes, hey, who's that 12-year-old kid? Like, that's your son. Oh, great. Hey, grass, that's your job. That's how I was revealed. Now, the gender reveal we went through last week was the worst because there was a pink and blue cake, like they're supposed to be, and I thought it was a cake, and I love cake, and I'm like, this is going to be delicious. And then it wasn't a cake. It was a smoke bomb. So that was a little disappointing, but both colors went off at once. Blue, and I'm like, oh my God, they're having twins, a boy and girl. And I said, oh my God, congratulations, they're twins. And then the woman goes, no, they're not twins. It's just one baby, but we don't think that we should lock the baby into any specific gender.
Yeah, nothing says like, let's be in therapy for the next 20 years if you're starting it off that way.
I'm like, this is a gender reveal party. What are we doing here?
Mm-hmm.
Let's get that baby out of your womb immediately. Or you should have just said, okay, we're going to reveal the gender. But you say, it's a girl for now.
Right.
No commitments. It doesn't matter, right? I don't care. If you want to change, like, look, sir, if you want to become a woman, all right, become a woman. You will be heinous. But become a woman. God Almighty, I'm telling you that even if you feel like a woman, stay a man and just suffer. Because if you become a woman, I shouldn't joke about that. Look, thank you for joining him. So our gender reveal told them that we're having
a girl.
A baby girl.
We're very excited.
Super excited, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing better than a baby.
Right.
All right. That we get to visit and hold and then send home.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm very excited about that. Yeah. So, and then today, our other big news. What's the other big news?
Oh, well, today is your mom's birthday.
Well, wait. First, we have to show the picture of the gender.
This is the gender reveal.
That's my
son. That's little Vinny and his girlfriend, Jennifer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very proud.
You know what I'm really happy about? My son is 34.
Yep.
And I am 58, and I know what you're thinking, and you're right. I do look great. The thing that I am the happiest about in all of this is I took him shopping for his Christmas.
Yeah.
And he is 34 years old.
Yeah.
And he's fit.
Yes.
And we wear the exact same pant size. I'm very happy.
That's what you're happy about. That's what you're gleaning from that moment. All right. Awesome.
I love that. All right. So now today is my mother's birthday.
Right. So today is Vinny's mom's birthday.
She would have been what?
She would have been 82.
She would have been 80.
You told me that this morning.
Wait, I asked she was born in 37.
I don't know. You did the math.
82. She would have been 82.
Yeah.
She would have been 82 years old today. She worked with us for a long time. Put my mother's picture up there, would you please?
Yeah.
That's
Marian.
My mother. That's her getting drunk in Atlantic City. I was with her. That's one of the last nights she ever drank. She lost a ton of money and quit drinking right then that night. But we have a great story to tell because my mother worked here for a long time.
A long time, yeah.
And she became friends with all the comedians. Mm-hmm. And this story involves my son and my mother. And because my son's having what would have been her great-granddaughter, we thought we would tell a story.
Yep.
One of my favorite stories to tell. My mother got, she was here, what, 10 years?
Yeah, something like that, 10 years, yeah.
10 years. And she got to know all the comedians. When she first came here, her first, very first night with Patrice O'Neill, and she said to me in the back room, I don't care for the language. He's up there saying the F word. That's what she said to me, the F word. Within 3 weeks, she's in the back. This effing paperwork doesn't match. She got such a trash mouth in such a quick time. But she ended up being friends with all the comedians. And one of them was Angel Salazar.
That's right.
All right. Angel Salazar was a big, hang on. Derek. Hey, Doug, come here. Derek, take that kid in the back and explain to him what shut up means. Kid, I can hear you.
And he's deaf.
No,
he can't
it's okay.
Hear
don't be upset. Yeah. No, Doug. Derek, or talk to him. It's all right. I got to focus on what I'm doing, and I know you're desperate. I understand that. But tonight, you're the Jets. You understand? You're the Jets. You're the Giants. You're the Washington football team. You're the Mets. You're Canada. Listen. Thank you. Look, she's so happy. I love that. I'm shitting on him, and she's so happy. You're going to get married, kid. All right, now. So my mother got to be friends. My mother got to be friends with Angel Salazar. And Angel Salazar was a womanizing little Spanish comic. He starred in the movie Scarface.
Right, he was in Scarface.
Scarface. And he tried to sleep with every single woman ever. And he got very close to my mother. And I know what you're thinking, but it did not happen. He tried, but it didn't happen. They just got to be friends. Now, my mother got leukemia.
Yeah.
And after a long battle, she passed away. And so we're having a funeral. And at that funeral, every comic that worked here for all those years came to that funeral. Mm-hmm. We had Lewis Black. We had David Tell. We had Dom Herrera. We had Kevin Meaney. Kevin James, I think, was there. And one of the big ones was Jim Brewer.
Jim Brewer.
Yeah. Yeah. See, that's the only one that she impressed
her. Yeah.
Yeah. So Jim Brewer's at the funeral, and my son,
he's a teenager at the time.
Is walking around his grandmother's funeral with an autograph book like we're at Disney World.
Starstruck. Oh, my God. That's Jim Brewer at Nanny's funeral.
Yeah.
And I'm like, Vinny, can you hear that? That doesn't sound good that you're excited. Who you're seeing at Nanny's funeral.
Now, let me tell you something. At one point, he came up to me and goes, Dad, Jim Brewer is here. Can you introduce me? I'm like, yeah, after the funeral, we'll meet Jim Brewer. But right now, try and remember that your grandmother's laying over there on the box. Now, Angel said he's coming to the wake, and he no-showed us. Now, my mother was a Catholic woman, so we had, you know, a full Catholic thing. We had four shows, you know, two shows each day, 2 to 4, 7 to 9. Packed out. Angel did not come the first day. He did not come the second day. The first day he called me up because, Beanie, I'm sorry I didn't come to the wake. Last night, I got fucked up at a party. Okay, maybe that's not the best excuse anyone's given for missing a wake, but whatever. Then the next day he calls me up. He goes, Beanie, you're not going to believe what happened. I couldn't make it to the wake tonight, but I'll be there tomorrow. And I'm like, Angel, you can't come. Don't worry about it. My mother knows you loved her. It's Friday morning now. It's just going to be the family, and you can't come. He's going, no, Beanie, I have to come. I have to say goodbye to your mother. I loved your mother. I'm like, if you loved her, you had four shows, you missed it. And he goes, no, I have to come. So I said, okay, Angel, you can come. You got to be there at 8:30 in the morning because we're going to say goodbye to my mother, and then we're going to close the casket, and the funeral begins. And he goes, I'll be there at 8 o'clock. Now, again, Angel is 5'2". He's a womanizer. He's actually Cuban, right?
Yeah.
He's Cuban. And he is the quintessential Cuban ladies' man. 8 o'clock comes, 8:15, 8:30. It's August 1st. It is 100 degrees at 8:30 in the morning, and no Angel Salazar. So I'm like, all right, that's fine. We're just going to say goodbye to my mother, and we'll bury her. So the family goes up. Everyone's saying goodbye. Everyone's doing their thing. The funeral director goes over the casket. He's got his hands on the casket. He's about to shut it, and Angel Salazar bursts into the funeral home in a powder blue three-piece polyester suit, sweating profusely, chest open to his belly button with a gigantic rosary bead and a cross hanging around his neck. And he goes, Beanie, am I too late? I'm like, Angel, it's too late. You can't say goodbye. Don't worry about it. We know you're here. He goes, no, Beanie, it's not my fault. I got fucked up in beach traffic. I'm like, okay, Angel, they are people going to the beach, but we can't do this. And he begs me, and I go, okay, Angel, go up to the casket quickly and say goodbye to my mother. And he walks up to the casket. He pushes the funeral director to the side, and he kneels down at the casket, this little Spanish guy in a Garanimals polyester powder blue suit. And my sister Lori goes, who is that Puerto Rican fella at the casket with mom? And I turn to her and I go, oh, that's that Chi-Chi from Scarface. And for whatever reason, Lori goes, oh, okay, that makes sense. And I don't know why it made sense to her. And so Angel says a prayer, and he stands up, and he does something I'll never forget. He bent down, he kisses her hand. Then he takes the rosary bead off his neck. He wraps it in my mother's hand, kisses the rosary bead, and walks away. And at this point, everybody is crying. The funeral director is crying. When a funeral director cries, one of two things happen. One, the check bounced. Two, Angel Salazar, I said goodbye to your mother. It was the sweetest thing we've ever seen. Everybody's crying like mad. And now the funeral director goes, okay, everybody get out. We're going to take it. And they close the casket. And now everyone leaves. It's me and the pallbearers. We're going to carry my mother's body outside. Now it is very hot out. Angel had been sweating very badly. So I pick up the casket. And I remember thinking to myself, I'm never going to laugh again. This is one of the saddest things I've ever done. I carry the casket outside with the people. The hearse door is open. We load my mother in, and I said to myself, I will never laugh again because this is just too sad. And I close the hearse door. Now, you know how sometimes the sun will hit a window and it'll turn into like a mirror? Well, that's what's happening. I close the door, and behind the hearse door, looking into the window that's been turned into a mirror by the sun, behind which my mother's body is laying, Angel Salazar is bent down looking in that mirror, and he's doing this. And he is fixing, and I laughed my ass off. And I said, that's it. I can still do my job. That's the funniest goddamn thing I've ever seen at a funeral. So happy birthday, Mom. We miss you.
Happy birthday, Marianne.
That's a fun story, right?
That is. So we have a little treat. So we met a customer last week. His name is Jay Wan. And he actually was on our game show, Fun Kid.
He did our game show last week. And we talked to him, and he's an artist.
He's an artist.
And we said, if you send us some pictures,
we'll
put it into the feed.
Right.
And he sent us pictures.
Right.
And these are the pictures. Take a look at with this, I don't know, 20-year-old kid.
No, he's 19.
19-year-old kid. Cycle through some more.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's
young
another
kid.
One.
He's in college. He's going to become an animator. What's the next slide, Crystal? There, look at the artwork.
Look at that. That's so amazing, Jay-Wan. Jay-Wan, stand up.
Stand up. He's
stand
right there. That's
so
Jay-Wan, everybody.
On you. Look at Jay-Wan. He's got great hair, too.
He's got great hair.
Great hair. That is great hair. Love
He's
it.
Got Mod Squad style hair. I love that.
Yeah.
I talked to his father today, and I said, because we're doing a makeover for a man.
Right.
And I said to his father, will Jay-Wan let us cut his hair? And the father said, absolutely not.
No way.
So Jay-Wan, congratulations. The artwork is beautiful. I didn't put the one above the nude girl, but I appreciated it. he sent one nude girl.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, beautiful girl. J1, right. You have very good taste in your cartoons. I feel like we should give that cartoon to that kid because he's still trying desperately. All right, now we also had a customer of ours send an artwork of the show.
Yes, yes, Phil.
Phil, our friend Phil, did a cartoon of the show. Show it up, Crystal, real quick. This is the artwork of the show. Phil, I know you're watching at home. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Phil. That was beautiful.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Vicky loves that because she looks fantastic. I look like Maury Povich after he lost too much weight. And Mark, to the right, has never looked that good.
Yeah.
And in the back, Derek looks exactly like Derek should look. Derek, where are you?
Yeah.
Derek, I hate to tell you this. I swear to God, when we saw it, we knew exactly who we were looking at. All right, give Phil a big round of applause. Yeah, now we got a big show. Let's talk.
Yeah, we have the band.
You know I love talking to the band. The band is my favorite, and they were swinging tonight. We got the whole band back tonight. You were gone again last week, right? How did finals go? Did you have finals yet?
That was in December, Vinny.
I don't know. I'm a dropout.
Oh, you went to record an album?
Take the microphone and tell us about that. You recorded an album where?
My friend has a house on Cape Cod, and we went there to do... We didn't end up recording it, but we got the songs written for the album.
So you started laying down the tracks.
What? Yeah.
That's good. What kind of album is it?
It's actually Kai here is in the same band. It's a bluegrass band.
Well,
started at bluegrass band, but we're moving into more rock.
That's unbelievable. And when will that be cut?
We don't know.
Are you going to put Joe on any of the tracks?
We might. Yeah.
Joe, you have to get involved. Give that microphone to Joe for a minute. Joe, why wouldn't you play in the rest of the band's tracks? You're friends.
I would. I'm just messing around. You know.
Of course you would, right, Joe? Did you have a good week?
Yeah, it was great.
Joe, last week you were a little out of sorts, but you were jamming. Is that because Alex wasn't here?
I don't remember being out of sorts. I remember being on fire.
No, you were on fire, but when we talked inside, you were a little bit upset because you didn't think that your mom got you the Christmas gift you wanted.
I don't remember that conversation. Vinny says I make up stories, but man, that's what you do for a living, man.
Joe, what do you got for a time? What are you gonna play? You gonna play the new single?
Yeah, why not?
I love that.
Yeah.
Listen, everybody, this single came out about 5 weeks ago. It's unbelievable. You can buy it on iTunes. It's one of my favorite songs. This is Joe Coon and the Hungry Hounds playing their brand new single, year-long Street Fight. Bring it to us, Joe.
Dogging you to split up dimes. Boy, go catch that pot of gold. Don't take what's mine. Howling wolves, they pray at night. And I would have no fears. I see the moon.
was awesome. That was
Joe,
so
that's
good.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable, Joe. And I'll tell you something right now. I love it more and more every time. Now we have our game show coming up. So if you are a contestant on the game show, we call you up here. Please do us a favor. Please wear your mask all the way up to stage. And then when you get up on stage, we need you to talk directly into the microphone for the game show portion of it. You guys ready to get it done? Derek, you have your contestants ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
We got them. Better system. Like, see, I mean, we just, yeah, just keep moving over.
This is our favorite portion of the night. The game show is ridiculous. You play for prizes, and Derek, do we have good contestants tonight? Great contestants, right? And the winner tonight, the winner will have a personalized cartoon done by Jawan. But you will have to be naked like the cartoon lady that he did, which kind of takes a little bit of... Did you show your mother the naked picture you did? Did you show it to her, Joanne? You sent it to me, and that one was secret. Why? Was that a live model, or is that just something you've been studying? Answer me, Joanne. Was it? Can I show it later? Was it a live model? Huh? It was a live model. Man, I gotta get into drawing.
Yeah, yeah. It's not working out for you.
All right. So I'm gonna get my mask off here. All right, we got three contestants. Call the first one up, Vic.
Okay, so the first contestant, we asked a little bit about each contestant. He works as a state field underwriter. He's godfather to Caitlin. I don't even know who the fuck Caitlin is. Why would you put that on? Scuba dives. His girlfriend is Dahlia. Please put your hands together for Bryant Mitchell, everyone. Bryant
Come on
Mitchell.
Down. Where is this human being?
Come on up, Bryant.
Yeah. This guy looks like an artist himself. He's got that little artist cap on.
Yeah. Yeah.
I hope Jawan has to draw him naked. That would fix you, Jawan.
Yeah. Oh, we need to move over. Oh, okay.
Is that better?
Yeah, I don't know.
All right, so let's get this guy. Oh, come all the way down.
Come
all the way down.
Oh,
take your mask off, Nat. You're up here.
Yeah, I'm too close.
I don't know, but you gotta get my give me a little microphone cord there, Vicky. All right, so let's talk. What do you do for work? Talk into the microphone.
I'm a state field underwriter.
State field underwriter?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
I protect you. God forbid you should die.
Do you work for the state?
I'm certified by the state.
Certified by the state? Yeah, talk into the microphone. And what do you do? You write what?
I do protection, life insurance, mortgage protection.
Man, it's amazing to watch one human being bore 120 at one moment. That is absolutely incredible. Congratulations. Yeah. Have you been on a game show before?
No.
No, I didn't think so. Are you married?
No.
No,
I did not think so.
His girlfriend is Dahlia.
Huh? Oh, Dahlia. I'm going to tell you something right now.
I've been set up. I decided I didn't write that.
I thought you were this guy's brother. I'm not saying...
You look good.
That you're not fun. I'm just saying that was your brother. All right, so, Vicky, let's get our next contestant up because I'm feeling that Dahlia's boyfriend is going to be very, very difficult to make laugh. All right, now.
Yeah.
Yeah, next up.
All right, so the next one is, hold on.
Donna.
Born in Brooklyn, lives in Colts Neck. That means she has money.
New
York City
person.
Guidance counselor. Hobbies. She just crossed up out a bunch of shit. I don't know. Where's Donna?
Donna
Aladna. Come on up.
Come on up, Donna. Donna, I don't know if you know this or not. Talk into the microphone. You take your mask off now.
Yes.
And I don't know if you know this or not, but the people at Colts Neck are so happy you're all moving into New Jersey.
Yes.
How long have you been in Colts Neck?
3 years. We lived
Talk into the microphone.
3 years. We lived in Middle. We got married, moved to Middletown, and then now we're in Colts Neck.
Ah, so you got fancy. You went from Middletown to Colts Neck. We live in Middletown, Don. I think you're better than us. Yeah, okay. Think you're better than us, Donna. We moved out of the slums. We live in Colts Neck now.
Screw you, Donna.
Yeah,
screw you.
Yeah.
Now, you're a guidance counselor in New York City schools?
I'm on maternity leave now for 6 years. I go back next year.
Are you having a baby?
New York City is your maternity leave for 4 years from your last child.
What?
So, yeah. So my son
you
is.
You have maternity leave for fucking 4 years?
No, for
I
six.
I need to get a different job.
For
six
years? I have two kids. Yeah. They give you 4 years
she's
from
20.
She's been on a maternity leave for 6 years.
So they give you 4 years from your last child. So if I have one right now, I have another 4 years.
Wait a second. Wait.
They don't
wait,
pay
back
you,
up.
Obviously.
Pump the brakes. 4 year maternity leave?
I didn't make the rules, yeah. I don't get paid, but I
if I were you, I would be spitting out babies every 4 years. That's fantastic. Your youngest child is four.
Four and my daughter's five, yeah.
Oh, my God. So you haven't worked in a long time.
Yeah. Oh, that's work. Yeah, my kids are 15 months apart.
Well, you're a guidance counselor. Technically, you've never worked.
Yeah. It's harder now, yes. Stay-at-home mom is definitely harder, yes.
All right. Well, good luck on the game show.
Yeah,
I don't want to stress you out. I know you're not working, so this is going to be a lot of work for you. Who's our next contestant, Vicky?
I'm hoping a fun one. Likes to laugh at dark humor, is a social worker, New Jersey local. Where is Day Domingo?
Day Domingo.
All right, come on in.
Come on up, Day. Nice to have you on board. Talking to the microphone. Take your little thing off there.
Hello, Day. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Talking to the microphone, Day.
Can you hear me?
Can you turn her up a little bit? I can't hear her. All right, so all three of you work for the state in some capacity or another. Is that right? Kind of?
New York State, yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah. That's why you guys are out on a Sunday night.
Well, you don't work for the state. You're certified by the state.
I'm certified by several states, yeah.
Okay.
All right, Mr. Oversharer.
How many of you think that, with the exception of the girl in the middle, our panel has never had sex?
Well, yeah.
All right, here we go. So we've got some rules and regulations. First of all, this is what you're playing for tonight. Crystal, we're playing for something different tonight. So, Vicky, tell them what the prizes are.
Okay, so I was against this, but I'm going to tell you what the prizes are. So we have chickens. So Vinny brought up 8 dozen eggs because he's throwing that in to the prizes.
Wait, they're not just eggs. They're organic, free-range, okay, gluten-free, Christian eggs.
Okay. So everyone wants to play for organic eggs that you can pick up at Wawa.
Yeah.
So anyway, so our grand prize is a $150 gift card and 2 dozen organic eggs. And I want to report back how you like these eggs because I'm the one that
you
has to
take all the eggs away. I brought some eggs for Jay and Lori. You got to... Okay, so you
how many? How many did you bring?
I brought, I don't know, 8 dozen or so.
Okay, sorry. Grand prize is 1 dozen eggs and $150 gift card. Okay, the second prize is a...
You're making this shit up as you go along.
I am.
The second prize is a sweatshirt.
No, it's a $75 gift card.
A sweatshirt.
And a dozen eggs.
We're never going to have money. All right, $75 gift card. And then what's the third prize?
A $50 gift card.
Eggs.
And a dozen eggs.
So everybody's getting a dozen eggs, no matter what.
Yes.
That's a bunch of crap right there. Let's get the game show done. Here's how it works. We can either assign you a question. We can assign a question if we want. Or we'll ask a question first, hand up, get to answer it. They can give me half the question. All right, here we go. Now, don't yell out if you hear it in the audience. And don't yell out up there unless you've been assigned the question or you got your hand up first. We'll tell you. Derek, you ready to keep score?
Yep.
All right, here we go. Go ahead, Vicky. You're up first.
All right. The average person does... what 13 times a day? Yep, guidance counselor.
Checks their phone?
Checks their phone. Nope.
Check your 13 times a minute. What is wrong with you? No.
I mean, you can just, day?
Goes to the bathroom?
Goes to the bathroom 13 times a day. That's a lot. That's a lot.
You should try a little roughage.
What about you, underwriter?
Takes a nap.
Takes a nap 13 times a day.
Absolutely.
Maybe in your field you
Absolutely.
Are.
Absolutely.
I'm thinking in your job field you do that.
That's only if you're a guidance counselor. That's only a guidance counselor nap. Do you want to tell them the answer?
Yeah, laughs.
Laughs.
Laughs 13 times a day.
Those are the three worst answers we've ever gotten.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe this bunch doesn't laugh 13 times a day, I'm thinking.
I feel like this next question, it's so easy, but it's not easy. It's a little tricky.
Yeah.
How many bases, think about that. Are there in a game of baseball? How many get?
Four.
Very good.
Yeah,
that's right. I tried to trick you. Okay, that's an easy one.
Okay.
Yeah, Vic.
Who is called the King of Pop? Okay, underwriter again.
Michael Jackson.
Now you got a lot of time to read.
Yeah. You know what? Let's throw him something he's not going to get. After the bedroom, what's the second most popular place to have sex in America? Way down the end. That's right.
Yeah.
A car?
Oh, my God. Look at that whore.
Someone's been in a car.
God bless you, you dirty little girl. She's on the board.
What are the five vital human body organs?
Go ahead.
Day?
Lungs, liver, heart, kidneys. Skin?
Skin, okay. So you said lungs, liver, heart, kidney.
Don't tell her the last one, Vicky. It's too funny she missed it.
Okay. All right. I'm a little worried for you. Underwriter?
Heart, brain, skin, lungs, liver.
Wrong.
Guidance counselor, you're in the school system.
You're in the, yeah.
I haven't been there in a while, though.
She hasn't been there in a while.
What did you say? Liver, heart, lungs, skin, no, brain. I don't know. What am I missing? Kidney? I don't know.
Can I tell you something funny about that contestant? Doesn't she seem just a little pissed off that she has to answer a question?
Yeah.
She's like, you know, heart, like, liver. What the hell am I doing up here? Tell them, Vicky. They got it all wrong. They're all wrong.
All right. Well, they all, I don't
know.
They
all got close, Vicky, but you have to name five.
Yeah,
you can't
since
name
day
four.
Through in skin, they all kept going with it. Day, you missed brain. You missed brain. You need your brain. Oh. You need your brain,
I
your heart.
Mine.
What?
I forgot mine today.
You forgot yours. Okay. Brain, heart, kidney, liver, lungs. Okay. All right.
All right. Here we go. I come in a lot of different sizes. Sometimes I drip a little if you blow me. But it feels really good. What am I?
Underwriter?
Eyelid.
I'm sorry, what?
Eyelid.
Eyelid? Do you blow your eyelids?
Sometimes.
I have no idea what's going on
Holy
in your
shit,
house.
Holy shit, Dahlia. Run. Run. This guy's got bodies buried somewhere. Trust me. Holy shit.
Guidance counselor?
Nose?
A nose, very good.
The girl down the end, you know what she was thinking, right? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. She does it in a car. Yep, she's thinking it. At least one in five people do this during sex.
During sex.
During. Day's thinking about what she does. All right, what is
I
Day?
I love it. Look at the face of that kid.
Yes. I'm not going to say what I'm thinking, but I'm going to go with my second answer, which is kiss.
Kiss. Only one in five people do during the sex?
You've obviously never been with a prostitute. All right, now.
All right. All right. You just throw out an answer?
Why? Open their eyes? I don't know. I can't think of
that. No, don't be ridiculous.
Not me. I'm just saying, what if I?
Not you.
Let me ask you a question. When you open your eyes, you're doing this?
Ah! I don't know. I'm just...
Jesus Christ, you scared me.
Take a shot.
Foreplay.
So only one in five do foreplay.
No, the answer is very bizarre. I've never done it during sex.
It's check your phone.
Check their phone.
You know, I was gonna
check
say
your
that.
Phone.
Yeah, right?
Do that.
Oh, look, that girl knew. She knew.
Gonna... Yeah, because she checks her phone. Like, I got places to go.
All right, here we go.
Who's texting me?
All right, this is gonna be a question I feel like the girl in the end can't get. I don't know what the score is. Name the Brady Bunch.
Okay, underwriter.
Marsha, Peter, Greg, Pete. I said Peter. Janice, Cindy.
There's no Janice.
Janice is the middle.
Janice.
Nobody
Jan.
Ever calls her
Jan.
That.
Jan.
Jan. Okay, go.
Jan. What do you have a birth certificate? Who calls her Janice? Jesus Christ, this guy's a stalker, I'm telling you right now. Technically, her name was Janice. And I know that because I was blowing my eyelids one day.
Bobby.
Huh? Bobby.
And Bobby.
Bobby.
Okay,
what are their
that's
parents?
The kid.
You want the parents?
Yeah, everybody.
Oh, mother of God.
Come on, that's so easy. What's the maid's name?
Alice.
Good. Mm-hmm. And the father is?
Mike.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And the mother?
People were yelling it out.
Carol.
I heard it back there. I think fuck it's him. Carol. He's not getting the answer.
No, that
was Carol with the C.
Yes, Carol with
Carol
the C.
Carol with
the
C.
It.
Okay, good deal. He got it then.
Yeah. Good job.
Janice. Who knew that?
Yeah. What is 75% of 1,000? Yeah, you should have got that.
750.
Very good. Very. I know Vicky, it was an easy Vicky, question.
Vicky. He is not fun. Don't let him answer. He could suck the fun out of a lottery win. This guy, how'd you get a date with Dahlia? World War II lasted how long?
Oh, 10 years.
10 years? Guidance counselor says 10 years.
No, get
7 years.
Seven years.
Down the end?
12.
12. 12. Did you pay attention at all in history class? No.
You know, it did last 12 years. The 12 years war. 6 years. 6 years. All right, good.
I don't have any more.
All right, ask that one, then I'll ask this one.
Okay. What actor voiced both Darth Vader and Lion King's Mufasa? All right, underwriter.
James Earl Jones?
Yeah, you're good.
I you know what? I am not giving him $150.
Yeah,
I'm not doing it. I will give $150 to a street bum first. This guy is not getting my money.
All right, last question.
Is he always like this?
He's funny?
Holy
shit.
She
said he's not funny right now, but he's funny.
Yeah, he's not funny right now for sure. This question, Derek, who's winning this thing? The guy down the end, right?
Yeah, the writer, yeah.
Derek, is anybody else even close? All right, this question is a championship question. Whoever gets it wins. What's white? Sticky, right?
Sticky. Mm-hmm.
Sticky. You wrote stinky.
I was rushing.
Jesus Christ, that's even weirder. Why do you white, sticky, and better to spit out than swallow? And this is the dirtiest question we've ever had. It is exactly what you think it is.
Cum?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Gum? No,
what
that's a good
one. What's wrong with you? It's a family show.
I said gum.
Gum, not cum.
Oh,
gum.
I just said cum.
No, I... All right.
Where's your mind?
My mind was on cum. No, it's not gum.
Not gum.
You only get one guess. You can't guess again. Down the end, young lady. Think about it, young lady. Sometimes you do it in a car.
Saliva?
What?
You know, you should blow your eyelids as soon as you can. Okay, let me give you a hint. Hopefully it's in your mouth at least twice a day, every day.
Oh, toothpaste?
Very good,
yes!
Down the end.
No,
all right, so Derek, what's...
The guidance counselor got it. The guidance counselor got it.
I said that.
Oh, I thought you said down the end.
I said very good.
Oh, okay.
No. Okay, Derek, what's the score?
You said that one won, though. You said the last one won everything.
No, I was only kidding. I can't take it away from him.
Yeah.
But you know what? If I did, this would have been his reaction. If I took all the money from him, he would have been like this. Oh, I'm sorry. What?
Oh, we need a tiebreaker.
We need a tiebreaker. All right.
Okay, all right.
All right, eyes forward. Think hard. Don't blow this question. Do not. If you blow this question, I take points away. What is the name of this show? Go ahead.
No, he can't win. You can't. You already won everything.
No, you can't.
No, you can't look.
She's in the New York City school system. They all cheat. No, you can't do it.
Day?
Vinny and Vicky? And,
oh. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
But she knew our name.
No,
that's,
no.
Day, that's close enough. You got second place. Close enough. We're going with it.
You got first, second, and third. I'm sorry you got third place. Right. Vicky completely screwed you. But you're going to get a dozen...
chickens?
Yeah, it doesn't. Not the chickens, the egg. Give them a big round of applause. Everybody, that's our game show for the night. Oh my God! All right, we got more show. You guys ready for some comedy? Let me hear you loud and clear. Let's get the band back up. Moving on down.
All right, guys, listen up now.
Hey, where's the band? Get the band. You got the band? Here they come. All right, pay close attention, everybody. First of all, thank you very much for hanging out tonight. And we bring our comics up. I want to hear a lot of noise, a lot of fun. Two great comics for you here tonight,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, very exciting.
Two unbelievable comics. And Jay and oh, my God, I just blanked on your name. Holy shit.
Lori.
Thank God.
Lori.
Well, you know, Jay is always the one talking to me after the show until 3 in the morning.
Oh,
and
okay.
I can't get rid of him. He won't let me go.
Sure.
He talks his head off. And he brought his father here tonight. Rumor has it, his father and I could get into a conversation that would never end.
Oh, boy.
That's the rumor we have. All right, so we have eggs for Jay and Lori.
Yes.
Right? We have eggs for the contestants. Mm-hmm. And we have 5 dozen eggs.
Well, we're going to give some for the Hart Pences.
The Hart Pences get eggs, mm-hmm. all right? Mm-hmm. And I think she needs eggs.
Yeah.
Oh, no. All right, now. You want some eggs? All right, I'll give you eggs, too.
I would have brought more. Do we have enough to give to these guys,
I brought a lot of eggs, Vicky. I brought a lot of eggs.
All right.
Anybody here watch the video today of me at the farm? Anybody? You watched it? You watched it? Mm-hmm. Anybody else watch it? It was a nice little farm video.
Oh, they did? You watched it? The egg video? No, clearly she didn't. She's really on top of things. You just want eggs.
You want eggs? You know what? I'm going to give you an egg. In fact, I'm going to airmail yours. No, I'm going to give you an egg. All right, so we have more show. You guys ready to meet some comics? Let me hear you loud and clear. Let's hear some music, boys, while we play them up. Hey, Derek, they got microphones for those guys? You got mics for them? All right, good deal. So our first comic was not on the show originally.
Right.
He came to hang out. A lot of comics come to hang out.
Yeah.
And I saw him here, and I said, hey, do us a favor, because our original book comic had to leave because he's doing things tomorrow for the state of New Jersey. So we're going to bring this guy up. This guy is one of our favorite comics here at the club.
Yeah, I love him.
And he's a regular all over the best clubs throughout New York City. And one of our favorites here. Please give us a warm, loud round of applause. Our friend Ty Rainey, everybody. Let him hear it.
Boom. Keep it going for Vicky and Vinny. And the Joe Conan, was it Hungry Hounds? Give it for the band, man. The band is amazing.
All right, yourselves. Look at this shit. He's got a soft fucking house outside. This shit is amazing. I am happy to be out the house. My name is Ty Rainey. Clap it up for me getting out the house for the first time. Yes! Thank you for having me. God damn it, you are saving my marriage. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, God damn it. Get the hell out the house. That is the secret to marriage is space, God damn it. That is space. Married? How many years? 25, I can tell by your posture. Look at, he's like, yeah, we do this shit. Yeah, we do this. We're out here in the corona laughing, let the COVID get on my gums and shit while I'm laughing, you know what I mean? You know, I'm trying to practice social I hate the mask stuff, though, man, you know, because I'm a social person. I can't tell if you're smiling or you're upset, you know? Everybody got the psycho eyes, you know what I mean? Like, everybody got the psycho eyes now. I don't know. It's crazy, you know? But please wear your mask, because I hate this fucking guy that comes in the store all the time like this. Yo, let me get some marbles right there. I'll be real quick. Let me just get some marbles real quick. I forgot my mask in the car. I'm so fucking sorry. I fucking hate it. Fucking hate it, man. It's a crazy world we live in, man. The Capitol was rushed yesterday, man. I don't know what the fuck's going on, right? It's fucking crazy. Shit is fucking nuts, man. I'm looking at the TV, shaking my head like, what the fuck is going on? Like, this shit is really going down? Like, it was on every fucking station. I didn't know what was going on. I thought it was like World Z or something morphed into some other shit. I was like, yo, they're doing some crazy shit with these fucking plugins on these phones, right? I didn't know what was going on. It's fucking crazy, man. I'm married, man. I got a kid, man. Anybody got children? Clap it, I got kids, right? Yeah? My heart goes out to you. I hope your kids are learning something, okay? I don't know if my kid's going to get graduate high school or get a degree in Fortnite. I don't know what the fuck is going on. I got to check on him every 5 damn minutes. Just check it. Just kick the door open. Just kick the boom. Like, you still doing something? You still working? You all right? You going to graduate? We good in here? People at home trying to work right now and is suffering. The economy's suffering. right now. I'm trying to pay bills online. Let me tell you something, people. We got the substitutes in the game, and it sucks. Customer service is taking a fucking hit, man. People are taking calls from home now. Do you realize this? How many homes have you called? Like, you called to pay a bill, right? And you get the customer service rep, and they're being super polite. But I had so many reps that I spoke to who don't change the battery in their fucking smoke alarms. What the hell is wrong with people? That's the most annoying shit, to be on the phone with somebody and all of a sudden, beep, beep, like that. You don't hear that shit? That's in your house. It's driving me nuts. Between that and the kid in the background yelling, "Mommy, I want juice," I'm like, fuck it, you guys are gonna have to work out this bill. It's ridiculous, man. But I understand, we're all trying to do something. We're still trying to keep in touch with families. Guys still doing the Zoom stuff with family members, or did you give up on them? No? Did you leave them hanging? Yeah, look at you. You're done, right? You're done. We're like, what, week 174 in this COVID shit? We still got that aunt that can't get the Zoom angle right on the camera? Do we have that, Aunt Brenda? She can't get the angle right. Or is that one with the sound? They always hop on the Zoom overexcited and shit, and they don't have any volumes. They're like... And everybody's on the Zoom in the boxes. We can't hear you. You gotta leave and come back. You can't. God damn, it's week 74. She still ain't got the fucking volume shit. And then you see just her eyes like this. She looks like a nosy neighbor because she's not tilting the laptop back. She just see her eyes during the whole call. You're like, just tilt the laptop back so we can see your whole face. She just holds the laptop up. Now we see her dirty ass ceiling fan. You have time. Clean the shit now, please. This is crazy. This is Sunday. I told my wife I was doing the show. She actually thought I was lying. She's like, yeah, right. I was doing the fucking show at 36 degrees outside on a Sunday. I'm like, you know, it doesn't really pass in the black household. Like, motherfucker, it's cold as shit outside. Who the fuck is doing the show? She was like, he's doing that shit in the tent. You don't know. You don't understand. I'm taking pictures and shit because I need Exhibit A. I need pictures of all this shit. I do. I need pictures of all the sternos and stuff. He tapped into hell and got this shit warm. Then I swear this is impressive. This is great, right? Give it up for Vinny. Keeping this going. This is damn impressive. Look at this shit. Look at this. The hound guys are out their father's garage. Now they're in fucking Vinny's soft house. This is the best ever. Anybody go and get the COVID test? Anybody go out there and get that? Round of applause. Anybody? Yeah, brave souls. Fuck that shit. I'm at home burning bacon and shit. If I can still smell it, I'm good, right? I'm burning bacon and shit. My wife's like, why is this so smoky? You're burning bacon. Like, you smell it, right? Like, yeah, I smell it. You're good. You're good. You're good. That's it. You know what I mean? Because you think you're losing your taste with stuff. You go in the fridge, you're tasting stuff. You're like, oh, my God, what is this tomato taste like? Is this old? Taste this tomato. Taste this tomato. Oh, my God. What the hell does relish taste like? Is this old relish? It's a little twangy. You don't know if your taste buds are dying on you as you're tasting shit in the fridge. You're like, is this old milk? Is this what, you know? Because I seen the test. You seen the test, right? It's crazy. They take like a, they got like a javelin and they do some shit like this. They say, lean your head back and nurses talk you into the wildest shit. That's what they do. They talk you into doing some wild shit because they know your blood pressure is raising and you're all calm. They're like, it's okay. It's all right. It's not going to hurt. Just stick your head back. We do this all day. Go ahead. And they take that javelin and they go, ha, right up your fucking nostril, right? They do that shit, right? And then what do they do? They go, okay, now we're going to do the other one. I'll be goddamn. If you poke me in my brain in one nostril and say you're going to test the other one, if it's in this one, guess what? It's in this one, too. You ain't got to do that shit twice, right? Come on, let's get smart with this medical shit. You did this one, it's in here, too. You ain't got to twice. You ain't got to poke me in the brain twice. Crazy stuff. I'm not. It's out of control, man. We didn't know what to do. We're wearing these masks and stuff. I'm tired of wearing my mask. I'm tired, right? You got a nice mustache. You don't want to wear a mask. Look at that fucking mustache. You groomed the shit out of that. Now you got to wear a mask. You're like, fuck, I got to wear this mask. Right? We can't even call out of work because we're at home at work all fucking ready. That shit suck. I used to love calling out in the parking lot. Anybody love that shit? Now you roll out of bed. You're like, goddamn. Now I can't be sick. I either got to be dead or, you know. You know what I mean? It's like, you can't make it. Well, you did. No. Don't want to do it today. You know? My nieces and nephews, they're having a hard time with school. My niece keeps putting a doll in front of the laptop, and she goes underneath the desk. She's just like, fuck it, I'm done with school already. I can read. I feel that Google can teach you a lot of stuff, man. Right? Yeah, get a Google education. Fuck it. I'm sweating my ass off up here. This is serious heat up here, because I ain't trust the shit either, you know. I did not trust the shit. I was still, like, testing it like this. I had my shoulder blade out for a second. I was like, I don't know. My core temperature, I don't know. I need a napkin. So I know. This is how you catch pneumonia. Thank you. How are these napkins? These all right? These been in your booty? You all right? They been in your back pocket? All right. Because you know when people put stuff in their back pocket, like, oh, baby, here you go. You're like, booty. Like, oh, my God. I was like, no. Thank you. No, I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Thank you for getting me out the house. Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah, I had to get out the house, man. My wife and I were bumping heads. We have very strong personalities. And my wife, we're always going back and forth with our personalities. My wife said, listen. She listened. I'm not trying to tell you what to do. I just want you to listen to what I'm saying and follow instruction. I said, that's telling me what the fuck to do. I've been married for 18 years, y'all. 18 beautiful years. Thank you. Thank you. Very happy about that. Very proud of that. 18 years. We got a 14-year-old son. We got a teenager in the house, man. Teenager in the house. You know, oh, you're going to clap for the teenager? Yeah. You know what that means, right? It's officially two dudes jerking off in the house now. It's a fucking teenager in the house. And we ain't got that much bandwidth. That's all I'm saying. It's just fucking your business class. It's fucking nuts. It's crazy. But I'm just happy, man. Just thankful. Just thankful to have a job still, working and everything like that. Ladies, all right? Everything's good? All right. You guys from the area? Who's from New Brunswick? Clap it up, you guys from New Brunswick. Man, this place, they got this town fucking lit. They didn't skip a beat. They just blocked off the road and said, fuck it, everybody gets soft tents. We're going to live out here. This shit's crazy, man. You're just functioning on the COVID, right? This is life now, huh? This is it. You guys got your little array of masks that you put in the laundry and stuff. Don't put them in the dryer. They'll shrink. You guys are doing that shit. How many masks have you shrunk? Huh? You hand wash yours? You fancy, huh? I shrunk everybody's mask last week. My wife was pissed. Everybody's mask was small as hell. You can make slingshots out of them. They're little as hell. They're like little pea shooters or whatever. It's just like my son's walking around like, look, I can put them on my nuts. Look, Dad. This fucking mask, man. Got service people coming. I just bought a house recently in Hamilton, New Jersey, man, over by Great Adventure. Just bought a house. And, I owned a house before, and now I realize how much it fucking sucks when shit breaks, man. It just can't call the man. He can't call the landlord anymore and lay back on the couch like, yeah, that shit broke. Go ahead, motherfucker. But, you know, now you got to actually stare at and do something about it. Like, God damn, this not running. I got to call the number on the side of it. You know, it sucks. You know. But this is great. I'm originally from Montclair, New Jersey. You know, thank you. You guys are a fan of high taxes, nowhere to park. That's great. I'm a product of public school education right now, man. That's it, man. Anybody public school education? Anybody? Oh, look at us, huh? Oh, all right. I'm old school. I'm an 80s baby, man. Shag carpet, lead paint, shit like that, you know? Like, round of applause if you've ever been left in the car while your mother and father ran into the liquor store. Anybody? Thank you. Don't be ashamed of that stuff. It was legal back in 82, right? Some of these even had the privilege of sitting in the car with a burning cigarette, right? Had a long-ass Salem 100. You know how long the 100 is? That's like a pool stick sitting in the ashtray. It's long as hell. It's the 80s. They didn't give a shit about us. We didn't have airbags, nothing like that. That death by dashboard. That's all we fucking had. You know, some of you, yeah, we have seatbelts. Like, kids got everything this year. They got baby seats and stuff like that. You had a fucking baby seat, kid. I could tell. Still got, yeah, you got harness prints still on your neck and shit. This is baby seat stuff. We didn't have a baby seat. I had my mama's arm and a snowsuit. That's all I had, man. Old school shit. Well, let me get out of here, man. Actually, my wife doesn't even know I'm here. I told her I'm taking out the garbage, man. I'm out of here. Hey, you guys, enjoy the rest of your show with Vicky and Vinny.
Put your little hands together for Ty Rainey, everybody. Oh my God, I'm in such a good mood. And I want to tell you something, I'm wearing my my new jeans, and they are, they're no stretch. No, thank you, ma'am. You like the jeans? Thank you very much. Very sweet. And I don't go for the stretch jeans, sir. I don't like stretch jeans on men. That's like walking and going, look, I want something that's going to fit me now and after I eat too much. Stretch jeans are for fat men. Do you wear stretch jeans? Yeah, God bless you, kid. The first thing you did tonight didn't piss me off. Listen. My wife said, get the stretch. I don't want that, all right? I don't want stretch jeans. Do you wear cologne, kid? Do you wear cologne? You do, right? What do you wear? All right, well, when you get older, you'll buy real cologne. I love cologne. You don't wear it, right? Yeah, I could tell. Nothing to say about it. A couple fast things just to let you know. This is how the rest of the show is going to go. I'm going to bring up your headline act right now. After your headline act, we're going to roll the credits. I got two guest spots coming in after that. And then we're going to listen to Joe Coon and the Hungry Hound play some great music for you. Are you guys having a good time? Yeah. I love Sunday nights here. I love Sunday nights here. I want you to go on your phone at the end of this. I want you to check in, let people know you're here. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to share with you, rather, all of Juwan's artwork will be on our Facebook page tomorrow, including the naked girl. You guys ready to meet your headline act? Let me hear you loud and clear. Brett, you got a microphone? You got a mic? This one here? All right, good deal. Listen to me. Our headline comic has been with us all weekend long. This guy is an absolute killer, one of the best comics working anywhere in the country. You know him from his work right now on the hit show Cobra Kai. Please welcome our good friend, Brett Ernst, everybody.
Keep it going for Vinny Brand, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, guys. Yeah, Vinny, I've been here all week. He asked me to do the show. Hey, Vin. He's fucking deaf. You better not be paying me in eggs, motherfucker. I better be getting a check. I don't want to get fucking 8 dozen eggs. What? That's it? Is that my bonus? Did I bonus out? I get an extra fucking half dozen? Bake a dozen? No, Thanks for coming out, man, risking your lives. I don't mean COVID. I meant coming to fucking New Brunswick. Jesus Christ. I'm not even afraid of COVID. I mean, whatever. I know it's real, but I just don't know if these restrictions are, you know, it's kind of stupid to me. Like, nothing makes sense, you know? So a guy with a barbershop who has 5 customers a day can't open up, but fucking Walmart, you know what I mean? Makes no sense. Like, we got to be in a 10. It's like this weird Irish legend, like, you know, the COVID virus will only get you after 10. Only if you're within 6 feet of another individual. So you better have your napkin over your face. You know, whatever. I've been traveling. I'm from here. I grew up here, though. I grew up in, like, Patterson, Passaic area. How you doing? I grew up in Jersey when Jersey was fucking Jersey, you know what I mean? When the Italians ran this motherfucker. When we, remember that good old days when nobody got arrested because everybody had a fucking PBA card? And everybody knew somebody. I'm only half, I'm mostly Sicilian. I'm also German. That's where I get my height from. My whole family's this big, man. I went to go see my family in Brooklyn. It was like fucking Gulliver's Travels. Like, wow, you're fucking, what are you, 5'8"? You're fucking huge, cuz. I got shit my whole life, because I was raised by my mother's family, you know. My grandfather used to always call me like half a Nazi and shit. And he'd make the sausage. He's like, you want me to put sauerkraut on it? Hey. I'm like, you want me to help you put the fucking dishes up in the cabinet? You short, boxy, no jawline having. Fuck. I have a cousin that's just overly Italian. It's like, dude, we get it. It's, you know what I mean? Just exhausting. Like, where's cologne to the gym? He's the guy that, like, when he goes to the deli, he overpronounces the Italian deli meats. You ever see that guy? Like, he speaks Italian. So he's like, yo, I'm hungry. I want to get a sandwich. Like, there's no G in sandwich, cuz. Hey, how you doing? Hey, everything good? You got any gabagol? You got gabagol? You got brisket? You got mozzarella? You got more? You got super? It's like you don't speak Italian, man. You're just pronouncing deli meats really loud. And we're at Subway. They don't have broccoli or rob for your foot long. I used to love going out here too, man. I used to look up to my cousin, man. Well, because, you know, when you're younger, you look up. You don't even realize what the fuck you're looking up to. You know what I mean? Like, when I was younger, I thought my cousin was awesome. He used to walk around with a fucking cologne bottle in his waistband. And then you get older, you're like, what the fuck? What? Why? Who does this? You know, I'm not making that up. How fucking tremendous is that? You're walking around with fucking, you got a gun and cologne. I'm Reform Guido. There was an intervention back in 98. They took my tracksuit away. And dude, I was awful, man. I see pictures of myself. I'm like, what the fuck was I? I used to go out. I don't know if you remember that one asshole in the club with just a vest on. Remember that dick? Who goes out with just a vest? What are you, Aladdin? I got Tim's on, like fucking going to Joey's. Remember Joey's in Clifton? That's a good place to get hit with a bottle. And Italians, like, we love going out, you know, because we like to let people see us, know the guy at the door. Like, it makes us like we're fucking somebody. You know, you go up to the door, you always got to drop 18 names. Yeah, like, don't worry, we'll get in. Like, hey, how you doing? You know Mario, Sal's cousin, Angelo, Vinny on Mikey's side, Anthony. Like, oh, yeah, yeah, just go over there. And you're like, fuck you. Your friend's like, we're going to get in. You're like, don't worry about it. You're like, you want a bottle, sir? Yeah, let me get a bottle, table, all fucking. And you get in. You're the only one in, the motherfucker. It's a Wednesday night. You're like, fuck. That's how you know you don't have shit going on when you're going out with your friends on, like, a Tuesday. We'd be out all night, too, man. There's always a guy, like, Italians, if you ever get a chance to go out with us, just do it, because you're not going to have to pay for anything. Because we always want to pick tabs up, because we want you to think we got more money than we really have. It's like a thing for us. Right, if you mention price to us, we get embarrassed. We'll want to fight you. Especially the old school guys, man. Like, my stepfather was like that too, man. Like, one time we went out for, because you got to understand something, we got a lot of pride. And I have to preface this, you know what I mean? It's just like, you know, don't fucking embarrass. Like, if you mention price that makes us think you think we can't afford it, you know what I mean? And then we get all upset. We'll make words up. Like, what do you mean? I look broke to you? I'm a fucking Bongiolini? I'm a fucking Peppa Gulp over here? You gonna tell me how much I'll buy the whole fucking restaurant dinner. We'll financially hurt ourselves just to fucking prove a point. I'll put your fucking kids through college, cocksucker. You want me to pay your mortgage? I'll take your fucking family to Europe. You want to fuck around? Guy's like, yeah, I do, actually. This guy's great. That's when we go out to eat. Like, we go out with every dollar we own on us. And It's like a $100 bill wrapped around like 20,000 singles. And we count our money so you can't see it, you know? Because you're like, what do I owe you? What do I? And the checks are always ridiculous because we overorder. You know, we go out. It's like, come on, you guys, let's just get for the table. Everybody pick. Let me get an $8 mod, some fucking about 14 months of that. You guys like clams? Get 2 dozen oreganos, fucking. And there's like 3 of us. And then a check comes. It's like, what do I owe you for everything? The guy's like, $800. You're at a diner at 2 in the morning. Like, you think I give a fuck $800? I'll fucking buy everybody oreganado. And then we take the money out and we count it so you can't see it. It's like, $800? I don't give a fuck, right? Here's 20. Fucking 8 hours later. And we always over tip, because, you know, but we have to tell you what to do with it. You know, we can't just get it. Like, here's an extra $500. Go get the kids a dozen eggs for everybody. Go get it. Go buy fresh eggs from Vinny for everybody. I always tip big, man. Well, I was a server, so that, you know, you feel for anybody who's ever waited tables, you feel for it. You see a server, yeah. You can always tell. I think Muhammad Ali said it. Like, you could tell a person's character by how they treat a server, you know? Like, it's the worst. You ever see people do this? You know, fucking, I'll kill your family. It's the worst, man. I did it. Nobody likes waiting on people. It's awful. Ask them. They hate you. Nobody who waits tables, like, you know your job sucks when you get mad when people just come in. You know what I mean? Like, I remember I'd be at work, people would show up. I'm like, fuck, man, why they gotta eat here? You know, like, it's their fault. And I'm in the back. Don't people eat home anymore? See, this is the problem with America. There's no family supper time. And you're like, hey, how you doing, family that can't cook? And mom and pop places are, and I'm not just saying this because Vinny owns this spot and I've known him for years, but places like this are the best because, you know, the family is like the staff and they care more about the food than you fucking assholes, right? Because in my opinion, the customer, you're second, you should come last, you know what I mean? You don't come first, because 99, who made up you're always right, by the way? Anybody with a job knows the customer's always fucking wrong, always. Mom and pops, they don't, you know, because they don't give a fuck. That's why they're the best to work for, because people complain. Nobody fucking cares. They're like, I don't like the chicken. You're like, don't eat it. Hey, maybe it's not for you. Here's your money. Go ahead. Go home. I need to speak to a manager. You want to talk to my aunt? Is that who you want to talk to? Listen to me. Get the fuck out of here now before I smack your fucking son that's trying to look hard over there. You kick him to sleep in front of the fucking restaurant. That's the way shit should go. Not the customer's always right. Like, I work for 2 corporate chains. I actually tried to do this on Comedy Central, and they wouldn't let me name the restaurant. Well, they cut it out. I didn't name the restaurant, but they cut it out anyways. Because I referred to it as the Shit Cake Factory. That place was awful, man. 8,000 items on the menu, you know what I mean? I don't know if it's the Cheesecake Factory if nobody figured it out. Fuck that place. Well, they train you like it's a real job and shit. Like, I'm in a classroom with a tie on, studying menu items, and you're just thinking your life. You're like, what the fuck, man? Like, I kept getting tested. I had to know every ingredient in every item in case one of you assholes is allergic to peanuts and you're on the floor like a dick. You know, the restaurant that cares about its workers, they absolve themselves from being sued. So if a cashew could take you out, and you don't tell me, and I don't tell you, and you're on the floor, you could. I'm the one that goes to jail, and I'm the one that gets sued. Which, by the way, you don't want to put your life in the hands of a fucking server. Like, if you're allergic to nuts, just tell us right away so we can find out if it's in it. Like, I don't know. You don't understand. None of us are happy. We're not even paying attention. Like, people would order. I wouldn't even fucking listen, I swear. I would just zone out sometimes. I wouldn't write anything down. I'm just like, okay. Okay. And then you get to the computer. You're like, what the fuck did they order? I'm not paying attention. And you're just miserable. You're rethinking your life choices, and you're in this classroom, and this is how you know your life really sucks, man, is when you're like 32 and you're cheating on appetizer tests. When you're in a classroom going, hey, what kind of onions are in the avocado egg rolls? Then it just sinks in. You're like, God, I'm a fucking loser. And there's always like that one server that's unbelievable, that loves being there. Makes like six figures a year somehow, fucking waiting tables. he loves being there. You ever get that guy? He's always wanting to hang out after work. You know, even on his day. You guys want to get together? We could have a Cheesecake Factory game night if you guys want to get. You're like, no, sorry, I'm getting pussy. I don't know what you're doing, fucking tool. He's always picking up shifts. I was lazy. I'm the minute I punch in, I'm like, who wants my tables? I was that guy. And then he jumps out of nowhere. He's like, you don't want them? I'll take them, bro. Come on, man. Fucking turn and burn. Let's make that money. He's got like 40 tables going at once. Bread everywhere. I got one table. I'm in the weeds. Because some assholes ordered hot. That's the other thing. If you order hot tea, I'll kill your whole fucking family. If you order hot tea, I'll follow you to fuck home. And all the servers are laughing because people are like, why? What's wrong with hot tea? Here's why, asshole. Now I got to stop what I'm doing and I got to do hot tea setups. Okay? I'm slammed, but because you're the fucking king and queen of England. And people order hot tea like they yawn, you know, like it's contagious. Like somebody be like, do you have any hot tea? And they're like, oh, ooh, that sounds good. I'll take one of those. And they're like, make that three. Then you're like, motherfucker, right? And I got to go run in the back, and I got to get the goddamn bakery plate. I got to put the doilies down, the cup, the fucking pot, the stick with the sugar on it, the honey, the lemon. I got this big-ass wooden box of like 8,000 teas from all over the world. I'll throw hot water on you, jerk off. You should be drinking coffee anyways. This is America. You tea drinking bitch. That's what we went to war over that shit. You ever hear of the Rainforest Cafe? Yeah, I worked at that motherfucker too, man. Goddamn grown man, I got animals and shit behind me. By the way, who came up with the concept of this place? Who got the funding? You know what I mean? When they're like, hey guys, I have an idea. Let's take the Cheesecake Factory, okay, and mix it with Chuck E. Cheese. And then let's put it in a rainforest in a mall. What do you guys say? I don't know. Can the servers dress like the crocodile hunter? You know they will. I'm in. And here you are, grown man, khaki shorts, fucking hiking boots. I got a fanny pack, got a frog on my shirt. It was a Creeke frog. They were indigenous to the rainforest. I know that because it was on the test I took. And I'm talking to adults and you got the fucking animals going off behind you. It's just embarrassing. No, you're like, hey, how you folks here? Fucking. You're like, yeah. And it would rain in there, and everybody's like, oh my God, it's raining in here. Because you hear, ooh, wow, wow, ooh. And everybody's like, oh, look, it's misting. It's the lights, it's not real. You got your fat kids. You ever hear the fat kids with the noises? And you always want us to entertain your kids. All the parents do it. Excuse me, do you have a coloring book and crayons? No. Why would I have toys on me? Well, Buca de Pepo has coloring book and crayons. Well, bitch, this isn't Buca de Pepo. What, the alligator answering questions about the Everglades? Is it good enough for your fat fucking kid? And he's sitting there, I want a coloring book. And the mom's like, well, you better get him something. Well, how about a fucking gym membership? The kid's six, and he looks like he's going to lose his toes. Fat fuck. Fuck that kid. No, fuck him. And he's fat because of you. Shitty parent. Asshole parent. That's why I love New Jersey. Anywhere else in America, people are like, don't say that. Yeah. No, fuck that fat kid. It was awful. Dude, I had a rainforest greet. I used to have to greet the tables. I used to have to walk to the tables. And you feel people making fun of you. You know what I mean? Like, I'm walking to the table, and you hear people like, oh, my God, is that a fanny pack? And they're like, hey, gentlemen, how you doing? I'll be your tour guide. You guys mind if I start your safari off with an appetizer? I bet that sounds fun, doesn't it? Yay. Yay. Can I introduce you in one of our margaritas? It's called a margarilla. Any of you happen to have a gun so I can blow my fucking head off and shoot that fat kid? Hey, Vinny, did I fulfill my egg limit or no? Do I have to keep going? You don't know. He's fucking deaf. He's the only comic that does crowd work, and then you have to repeat yourself fucking 15 times. All right? Like, dude, why are you doing crowd work? So where are you from? Huh? What was that? I can't hear you. Let's get your job. I'm a mechanic. What? You're a psychiatrist? Dude, I've been doing this place forever, man. Fucking 17 years I've been coming here now, right? Oh, yeah, 17. Thanks. Hey, be careful. I'll egg your fucking house. I just, like I said, man, I mean, just keep supporting this place, man. You know, he's doing everything he can to keep it going, man, and just for the entertainment. I know you people, look, I travel a lot. I spent most of my time in Florida, you know, during COVID, because I knew they didn't give a fuck down there. Masks. They're not even wearing rubbers, let alone masks. People are eating ass at like 3 in the morning. You know what I mean? Nobody gives a fuck down there. Vin, you want to come up? No? How's this work? I know we want to. Yeah, of course, man. Vinny Brand, ladies and gentlemen.
Brett Ernst, everybody. Brett Ernst. You know, Brett, I loved having you on this show. But I just want to tell you in front of everybody, it's probably not politically correct to pick on deaf people.
Now you're all PC?
No. No, it's just right before I write your check, I'm thinking about it. And it's coming to mind more and more.
Yeah, I didn't even think you were paying me, for real. This is like...
Are you having fun? Did you enjoy the show?
Yeah, I love it, man. This is great. You know, Brett's
been coming here for 17 years,
pretty much, yeah.
And I've seen Brett, yeah.
Yeah, no, yeah, it was 7 years in, so that was the first time you ever booked me.
Yep, and I have seen Brett probably, I don't know, 60 times, whatever. I've never seen this guy have a bad set. This is one of the best comics working anywhere. It's fantastic.
Well,
and that includes Now, let me tell you something about Brett, and this is not supposed to be part of the show. You people watching at home, you're not supposed to get this. But this is what
you,
Brett
don't
did.
Bring that up. I don't know.
Can
what
I please?
I don't know which way you're about to say. I'll stop you, though.
Now, can I tell the story?
Go ahead.
All right, so Brett is on stage. Now, Brett is a guy. Look at him, okay? Brett's not a guy that if you're another guy, you should not be pissing him off. Look at him. He's no.
I've had my ass kicked plenty of times.
Yeah,
You were in a fight, but I've had my ass kicked plenty of times. But that's the other thing, by the way. I'm sorry. I don't mean to.
No, that's right. Brett is a guy that if you want to challenge him to a fight, it actually, in his head, he goes, oh, it's going to be fun. Like, if you challenge me to a fight, I'm like, oh, this is going to hurt. I don't want to do that. Brett's like, okay. So there was a night here at the club, and there was a monster guy. Do you remember?
No. Of course I remember. I knew this is where you're going. It's uncomfortable because this is an almost fight story.
It's a funny story.
All right.
Okay, the guy is gigantic. He's and the guy's drunk, and he's being a jackass like yourself. Anyway, the thing is, I'm just kidding. Let me tell you something. You are the size of one of this guy's legs. Do you understand? This guy, he was huge.
Can I just say something? Anybody who has ever been around, you know, a dude that big can't fight. You know what I mean? They can't fight. He's like, fuck, oh. You're like, really? You just fucking just go in. And he's just like, you know, and he's doing a lot of this shit. And it was annoying. And his girl's the one that ran her mouth. And I can't see past anything. And, you know, and this guy's woofing. And then I'm like, whatever. And then this guy starts throwing tables.
It's unbelievable. And
in the middle of a fucking show.
Yeah. But the guy said something like, you know, I'll kick your ass. And Brett goes, all right, right now. And I'm like, there's 15 minutes left. We have to get one more round of drinks. Please do this after. I'm trying to make a living. And I don't think it's going to happen. And the guy stands up. Now, when he stands up, my manager, Mark, and Derek go running in front of the guy.
And once they did that, I back off because now I'm a punk. No. Right? Well, there's two guys on him. I'm not going to fucking run my mouth now.
Brett was being a gentleman. Brett offered to fight after the show. But the guy was in a rush. He wanted to get the fight in, and he thinks he's going to kick Brett. And he thinks, because the guy's so big, he thinks Brett is going to be like, no, because that's what I would have done. I would have been like, let me get you a beer or a car or any fucking thing you want. I don't want to fight you. So Brett's like, all right. And the guy stands up, and he's a monster. Now, on the security tape, Mark gets in front of the guy. Derek gets in front of the guy, and he plows through them like butter. And Brett's on stage like this.
No, I was already down.
Yeah.
I was already on the floor.
You were on the floor, but you were ready.
And then I jumped back on stage. What right.
Now, we have to... Now, they end up... This is how big the guy is. They end up getting the guy to the ground. They get him to the ground. And Derek and Mark, both of whom, added to combined, they weigh probably 450 pounds. I'm not calling them heavy. I'm just saying... And this guy plants his palms on the ground and just does a push-up with 450 pounds on his back. And Brett's like, this is going to be great. And Derek knows the sleeper hold. Derek put him to sleep. And I get down next to him. You ever seen when someone wake up from a sleeper hold? And now this is a shit show going on. Now I bend down.
We were sold out, by the way.
Huh?
We were sold out that night. I was doing very well.
Wait to hear the... Yeah. He was killing. That, believe me, the story ends so good for Brett. So I get down next to the guy's face when he comes to, and I go, hey, we're going to let you up, but you got to leave. And the guy's like, I'll leave. We go out. It's an absolute shit show. Brett goes, all right, let's start the show again. Any other comic would have tanked. For the next 15 minutes, he absolutely destroyed and got a standing ovation.
It was 25 minutes.
25 minutes standing ovation.
And just for the record... Most of the guy's friends stayed because they knew he was a dick.
Yeah, Oh, that's true.
He was just drunk. Whatever.
He was a drunk. Do you know that week, I called him up. This is how I handle shit. The guy called.
You gave him eggs?
No.
He's like, listen. I apologize. Things happen. I got 2 dozen eggs coming for the family. They're from my chickens, everything fresh.
Brett, I am not making this part up. You never heard this part. I met him at the Starbucks in Middletown. He pulled up in his monster truck, which of course he drives. He's got a gun rack in there. He's got 4 pit bulls. The guy gets out of his car, and I'm like, man, I hope this goes right. And I gave him two free tickets for the club to just shut him up. And he's been in a bunch of times since. But he's
told you, he was a nice guy, man. He didn't want to do it. It was his girl was getting him.
His girl got him worked up. Which, it's always.
We all know what that, you know, guys know what that's like.
Yeah, this kid didn't want to talk tonight. His girl got him all worked up.
Which one, this guy?
Yeah, this young kid right here.
Nice kid.
Brett, how old do you think that kid is?
I don't know, 22, 23? Yeah.
I think he looks like he's 16.
No, I could tell. Look, he's doing well. His whole table's good over here. This kid's a little gentleman right here. He's got three girls with him.
He's got three girls.
Leave the kid alone. He's cashed up. You can't tell.
So, Brett, let me ask you something. I'm going to put you on the spot. I don't mean to put you on the spot.
No, we got a better things to talk about than go ahead. I want to hear it.
No, I want to know if you will do one more bit. Will you do?
Yes.
You'll do it?
That one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't mind?
No, not at all.
Can I get off stage and watch you do it?
No, let's talk some more. Let's talk about how the fuck I bombed and other things that happened during my sets.
You never bombed, even after a fight you murdered. That's my point.
I know, man. I'm joking.
Who would you? Now, you went on the road with what's his name? Vince Vaughn.
Yeah, we did the Wild West tour like in 08. It came out as a documentary that came out in the theaters. We toured in 06, but it came out in 08.
Yeah, it was unbelievable, right?
Yeah, it was me, Sebastian Maniscalco, Ahmed Ahmed, John Caparulo. It was pretty dope, man.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it was a good time. I was like going on, and I had already been doing comedy since 96, so I can't do math, so whatever that is. and then that was like the first major.
Now, we weren't the first club to headline you, right? You were headlining the other joints.
No, you were one of the ones I was trying to get in.
Right.
At the time, but, you know, it just wasn't adding up. And then when it did, that's when it happened.
I got to tell you, when you come in, the staff loves you. We had staff members that worked all weekend that came in to see your set again.
Well, yeah, well, you know, that's good. I don't know how to, I don't know, yeah. Thank. I don't know, man, yeah. But we also hang out, and I think I clipped a couple of them back in the day, too. So. I'm joking.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the right way to say that in 2021. I clipped
nobody
a couple.
Listen, nobody cares.
No, they don't care.
Nobody
when you
cares.
Go to a comedy club, you can't give a shit, right?
But I think all that political correct shit is exaggerated, all that crazy shit. Because, again, man, I travel a lot. These are just interesting, funny things to watch people act like assholes. Most of America is pretty fucking in the middle, grounded, you know.
Yeah.
You know, you're going to have your wackos, so.
Yeah.
You know. But no, it's I always get, you know, it's like a second home to me.
Yeah, well, we love having you here. And you like the tent, by the way. Tent's great.
Tent's strong.
Yep.
It reminds me of like remember in Night at the Roxbury? Remember their club? It was like, we're gonna build a club that's outside, but you have to get inside to be outside. This is the Night at the Roxbury club where we're outside, but we're actually inside. But it's part of these stupid COVID restrictions, you know?
The COVID restrictions are very significant and they're hard. But when we built this, I told people we'd be open through the winter. They didn't believe me. Here we are, January 10th, warm as could be, social distance safe.
You know what else? Is great? Is that you could rent this thing out for like Little League award ceremonies.
Absolutely.
And shit like that.
And I will. I will do it. This cost us so much money.
I could imagine.
But we bought it. And everyone said, oh, you're crazy. What are you buying it for? I said, they're not going to flatten the curve. This is going to be a two-year headache.
But you can still use this, like, now to do stuff before people come in.
Yeah.
Can I do the Italian thing?
Yes.
You should have come so. My cousin does tents. Why don't you come fucking see? Next time. Why don't you come? My cousin owns the heat. I'm sick right now. You should have told me we're putting a tent up.
Brett, you know that the guy that did my tent is Italian.
Of course he is.
Of course he is. So listen, I'm going to ask you that bit, because then we're going to do a short interview inside later on, right?
Yeah.
Which I don't mind doing. This, I'm going to ask Brett to do a bit right now for you.
This is solely Jersey. I wrote this. This is all Jersey. There's a lot of people in our age demographic here that will get this.
Yeah, kinda, I think.
And when I started it was great, and then nobody understood it anymore. But you'll see when I talk about it. But
I think they're going to get it right now. I'm going to get off stage.
The
you're going to watch
might not.
Brett Ernst for five more great minutes. Let it hear Brett Ernst.
You got it, Derek. Thanks, buddy. One more time for Vinny, ladies and gentlemen. By the way, the clipping joke is because you're not, as there's like a rule in comedy where you're not supposed to clip the staff and they're not supposed to interact. So that was supposed to piss him off, but he didn't. Some of you didn't get that, but he just wrote, he probably didn't hear it either. No, I wrote this joke. This is, it's about roller skating. I don't know if you guys remember going roller skating. this is how you know you're old, by the way. No, but the rink I used to skate at was, it was United Skates of America. I don't know if you remember that chain. Dude, in the 80s and 90s, man, and I try to tell the younger people this, like, the roller rink was like a nightclub for kids, right? Because you would go to the rink, and then you would see other kids from other neighborhoods and shit. You know, it could get violent, you know, shit could happen. But it was mostly you wanted to pick up other little girls, and, you know, you were just a kid. Right? You throw makeouts behind the video game machines. It was a good place to be. And when you went there, you wanted to look cool, but it was very hard if you didn't have money, okay? Because kids who had money, they could bring their own skates. Like all the rich kids had like the black, guys had the black skates, the girls had the white ones. But if you were broke, you had to stand in line with like this little raffle ticket. And you would have to rent your skates. They were like these shit brown rental skates with like this big ass orange stopper in the front. And the shoelace went halfway up. There was never no ankle support, right? You always needed like 20 pairs of socks because they never had your size, right? Because I'd be a kid, the guy would be like, hey, son, what size are you? I'm like, I'm a 7. He's like, well, we have a 6.5 and a left and a fucking 14 and a right. And then you'd put your skates on and your feet would just go all over the place. And there was always this one guy at the rink that all the kids looked up to, right? And my roller rink, his name was Tony. And he was Italian, could have been Spanish, I don't know. He smelled phenomenal, by the way. And he could bring his skates and everybody would be like, oh shit, it's Tony. And he'd fucking walk in and he could do all the cool tricks, right? Like he could do that fucking that rubber leg thing, and, right? And he could turn, you ever see, he'd turn the corner like this and, you know, and everybody looked up to him because you were like, oh shit, he's cool. Like all the girls wanted to skate with him. All the guys were afraid of him. Did I mention he was 30? Did I mention that? You know, as a young kid, you're like, wow, Tony's awesome. You know, then you get older, you're like, that guy's a fucking pedophile. Like, why is there a grown man hanging out with 10 and 12 year olds at the roller rink? And he was a dick too. We were all afraid of him. Right? Because, you know, you're trying to skate and he would just come by and he would chuck you in the wall, right? And I don't know about your rink, but it used to suck because I don't know why. It was like brick or cement and then just a rug. Right? It didn't cushion the blow, so you got hurt twice. Like, when you hit the wall, you got the impact of the fucking cement and then you got a rug burn on the way down. And as you're laying there, Tony would come around and jump over you and make you look like a fucking asshole. So I'm 10 years old, right? I got the shit skates. And me and my friends would just play video games because we were afraid to go out on the floor, right? So you're just playing video games, but every once in a while, you have to go out there because you'll hear like that one good roller skating song. Turn it up. You're like, oh shit, that's my song. I'm going out on the floor. Your friends are like, what about Tony? You're like, man, fuck Tony. You're like, woo! I'm skating on the rental skates, right? You're feeling good about yourself, right? Like you might get a couple skates, and all of a sudden, here comes Tony. And then he do his little shuffle, his little.
There's a party in the house and we'll be rocking tonight. So bring your body with you, baby.
Then he turned the corner, all the girls want to touch him. He's like. And then he'll bust his move. Hey guys, listen, man. Keep supporting the club. Love you, Vin. Love you, man.
Come on, make some noise for one of my favorites, the one and only Bret Ernst, everybody. You guys are a great audience. I'll tell you something right now. That is our show for tonight. You can do me two favors. You people watching at home, you people here in the room, please go on your Facebook right now. Share the show. It's very important to us. We started doing it for people that couldn't come out. We're going to keep doing it because I'll tell you what, it's going to be a long winter. We'll be here all winter long. We have some great shows coming up. Rich Voss coming up. Our friend Sam Morrell coming up. We have Tommy Davidson coming up. Who else, Derek? Who else? Oh, yeah. Well, who is it? Tommy Davidson? I'm missing one.
Jeff Dye, Rich Voss.
Jeff Dye, Rich Voss. Who else? Yeah, hey, clap for Derek, everybody. 7 days a week here. We had a real big show tonight. How about a big round of applause for our friend Ty Rainey? Let him hear it. Brett Ernst, everybody. Brett Ernst. Clap for Joe Coonan and the Hungry Hounds, everybody. Vicky Brand, everybody. I'm Vinny Brand. We love you guys. Thanks for coming out. Roll the credits, people. Roll the credits. Hey.
Yeah.